Nigerian students sponsored to study in England by the Niger Delta Development Commission on Monday held a fresh protest. The protest is over funds not being released for their scholarship. The 94 scholars displayed placards with various inscriptions as they gathered in front of the Nigeria High Commission in London, United Kingdom. Joining us live is John Aberdeen, who is an NDDC postgraduate master's student in the UK. Thank you, John, for being with us this evening.
Thank you for having me.
Right, bring us up to speed with what is going on at your end. What is the true situation as at now?
Thank you for this opportunity. We are 2018 NDDC postgraduate scholars. We actually awarded this scholarship on the 24th of October 2018. And then we proceeded to the UK and different parts of the world, like the US and Canada and so many other countries in Europe for our foreign postgraduate scholarship to begin our studies. But some of us couldn't resume immediately for financial reasons because the NDDC didn't pay our takeoff grant. So we had to defer to 2019 to be able to come for our studies. And from when we began our studies till now, none of us in 2018 is yet to receive a dime from NDDC. Our tuition fees has not been paid. Our upkeep allowances has not been paid. We've tried severally to communicate to the NDDC to tell them, to beg them, to plead that they should pay us our tuition fees. This is not something we are supposed to be pleading. We are not supposed to be pleading because they gave us this scholarship. We merited this scholarship. We wrote exams. We did the CBT exams, we did interviews, and we were selected. Over 200 students were selected. So at the end of the day, 94 of us have not been paid because we were not able to resume with our set. So since that time, since 2019, that most of us started, see now, none of us, the 94 scholars, have been paid. That is why we are calling that Mr. President should prevail on the NDDC so that we are paid in full. We recall that on the 4th of August, 2020, this year, our president, Mr. President, instructed that all scholars that are being owed all over the world should be paid, especially the NDDC scholars of both the 2018 and the 2019. But as of today, only the 2019 scholars have been paid. The 2018 scholars were not paid. Some in 2016 that were still owed were settled. But they deliberately skipped 2018. And we have been raising alarm. That was why on the 16th of September, we came out again for another peaceful protest. So air our grievances that we have not been paid. What is going on? Right. The commission, why did you deliberately skip 94 scholars? And the commission came and said they were coming to do verification. They will come and verify us to check that the authenticity of our award. This is a scholarship that we awarded. Fine. They came on the 12th of October to the UK and they completed their verification and verified the 90, they came a week later and verified the 94 scholars. And they were supposed to begin and commence payment on the 12th of October. That was what they promised to do. But this is 2nd of November. Right. And as we are speaking now, nothing has been done. No payment has been made. That
John,
is why we have come to
understand.
Cry out. Because the same commission have accused us before that we are hoodlums, we are miscreants. We are not hoodlums, we are not miscreants, we are not good scholars. We are here life and direct. So that is why we are here. We came out today to ventilate our displeasure.
All right, John, let us understand. Help us understand if it is a question of paying in batches, because I also do recall, as you mentioned, that the first time 2019 batches protested, the government, you know, a representative of the government clarified that they had made payments for 2019, but yes, 2018 hasn't been paid. What are they saying? Have you heard anything why they've not paid you? Because, again, you mentioned that they were in the UK and they have verified you. What are they saying to you? Clearly, that is the reason for not paying you.
For now, they have not given us any cogent reason why we have not been paid. They told us that they've compiled our names. Our names have been verified. We will be signed up and our details have been submitted to the CBN. This was as at the 12th of October this year. Now, how many weeks after? This is the fourth week after they promised and after they told us that our payments are ready. We've not received any payments from them. And they keep on pushing us. This week, next week, our schools are tired. They are beginning to see us as liars. Are these guys actually scholars or not?
And so which brings me to confused. my next question.
We have been talking to them, even the representative of...
And that brings me to my next question, John. What's the situation in school? Because if you're saying since 2019, you've not been paid, are you still allowed to be in school? We hear cases where students are being ejected out of the hostels. What's the situation for you and the other 93 others? You said you're 94 of you. Okay,
the situation has been very tough for all of us. We have been through very bad situation. Now, the UK is planning to go into another lockdown from Thursday this week. Many of us have been suffering, especially in this COVID-19, with this COVID-19 pandemic. First of all, our tuitions have not been paid. Our schools are sending us mails every time, demanding that our tuitions are being paid. The emotional trauma, the emotional stress has been so hard problem. In coupled with that, the COVID-19 situation and the COVID-19 pandemic has made it difficult for us to even survive. Many of us are working in care homes under very deplorable conditions, just to be able to get food to eat and to be able to survive in this hard time. And these are the things we have tried to make the commission understand with us. A few of us are falling ill as a result of the pandemic and have had to bear expensive medical bills to be able to cater for themselves. Some have been locked out of their online portal. Some of them that have even completed their dissertation, the schools have not allowed them to submit. Then those that are planning to complete in their studies, they've been given ultimatum to make payments. And we are continuing to see these things all the time. We send mails and mails to the NEDC, to the commission, but nothing seems to be happening. This is why we have decided, and we continue to say that we will continue to make our voices heard until we get a positive response. And the positive response that we demand this time is that they make payments. We have been very patient with them. It's over 2 years now that we've been owed this scholarship fund. Our scholarship award is over 2 years. It's more than 2 years old. And we are begging them that they should make payments. We are pleading with Mr. President, who has given an order that the NDDC should make payments, that they should comply. NDDC should comply with that order and make payments. That is all we need. That's our concern. So that our schools will stop disturbing us and feeling embarrassed. And so that those of us that are about to complete our studies, we can graduate. And so that we will not be handed over to the Debt Recovery Office. These are so many things. Not only in the UK, even those in the US, they've also been locked out of their portal. Some of them cannot register for a new semester, especially those in the PhD. Like I'm an MSc student. But those in PhD, some of them cannot register for a second semester because they have 3 years to go. So these are some of the challenges we are facing. And that is why we came out to express our displeasure and to let the world know that we are real persons. To put a face behind the voices that you've been hearing and seeing on Twitter. 2018 NDDC scholars are real persons. I'm just one of them. There are so many of us, and we are asking the NDDC to please do the needful, pay our tuition and our upkeep. We don't have any problem.
Hi, thank you so very much, John Ebadin, for sharing your thoughts. Quite tough experiences there. We hope that the Nigerian government, through NDDC, would listen and do something speedily for you.